Hi, I'm Linda with Clergy Image, and I'm going to talk to you about masks, but I also want to show off my snazzy shirt. We got these for the members of our team because we have been out and about in areas in California where they have a very strict stay-at-home policy, and so we wanted to make sure people knew that we had a reason to be out and moving. But this is our COVID emergency sewing is the group that we created to help coordinate volunteers and being able to cut fabric and cut supplies and put together kits and deliver them to people and pick them up and bring them back to us so that we can ship them to frontline workers. So we've sent masks to hospitals, acute care centers, assisted living centers. We've provided them to doctors and nurse practitioners who are working inside the prisons, to public defendants who are working with clients inside prisons. So a whole different cross section of people that we are providing masks to. And now we are making them available to our customers free of charge. So this is our mask. It is, it'll come to you flat like this. It has pleats, two elastic straps. There's a pocket in the inside for a filter. And then at the top here is a little piece of metal, kind of like a bread twist tie, that you can use to squeeze around your nose to make the mask seal better around your face. These are filters that you should have gotten with it. You can wear them in two at a time for extra protection, or just one depending on what's more comfortable for you. So the first thing that you're gonna wanna do is insert them into the mask. This is the inside of the mask where the pocket is. You're gonna open up the pocket and you're going to put the filter in. You're gonna spread the pleats out a little bit to do that, and you just wanna make sure that the filter is laying in there flat and it's kind of near the top so that it's gonna be covering your nose and mouth area. So this is the top where the filter pocket is and the metal piece. So to put the mask on, you're gonna take both straps together and just pull it down over your entire head. Then you can either put this strap up, or I prefer to just pull the whole mask up. When you get up to the nose, you can see how there's gapping here. You're gonna squish that metal in and it will seal it towards your face. If you are wearing glasses with your mask and your glasses are fogging up, it's because your mask is not sealed in this area and the air is escaping up. The other place that you want to watch is, you can see right now, because I have those straps are still down, this gapping here on the sides where it's doing this. That's also a place that air is escaping. So when I'm breathing, we want the air to be going in and out through where the filter is, because that's giving you and the people around you the most protection. So we want to try to seal those areas around the face. So when you put it on, put your top strap up on the head, and you can see how this keeps it off of your ears, which is one area that we get a lot of comments about because they're pulling on your ears. When you have the mask on, you then want to pull this piece down so it's below your chin. So you now have a good seal on the sides, up here, and then down below. This is loose, but it's sealed here against my chin so the air is not escaping down below. If this strap is uncomfortable, it slides right through these casings, so you can pull here and you can get it looser on this top part and tighter on the neck, or you can pull down here and get it looser on the neck and a little tighter on the head, whichever is most comfortable for you. To take the mask off, you're gonna want to grab your hands on the inside and take it off. You don't want to be touching the front of the mask, either to be adjusting it, scratching your face, moving it around, or when you're taking it off to grab it on the front. If you are going from errand to errand and you wanna remove it in the car, you can do that. Just make sure, again, to be really careful that you're not touching the inside of the mask with your hands, particularly after you've touched the outside of it. The pleats are going to pull out as you're wearing it, but some people like seeing the edge of the pleats. So if you want to iron them back in, you can just hold it flat like this and iron over it. You can do that. You can wash this in hot water. It's 100% cotton. They've been pre-washed, so they've been pre-shrunk. You can put it in the dryer on high. You're going to want to do as hot a temperature as you can to sanitize the mask. The reason that we are offering more than one mask is that if you've got two, then you can be washing one and have one ready to go with you all the time.